Hello everyone, how is it going? My name is Ubaida, I'm a software engineer at Facebook, and welcome to my channel, Quicksort. Today we'll discuss about Dutch national flag problem. Dutch national flag, aka DNF, is a very well-known algorithmic problem for coding interviews, especially for FAANG companies. It was first proposed by Edgar Djaikstra. We all know Edgar Djaikstra, one of the brightest minds in the history of computer science, who happens to be a Dutch by nationality. By the way, he's also one of my favorite computer scientists ever. The flag of the Netherlands consists of three colors, white, red, and blue. Our objective is to group the colors together and maintain the correct order. So if you look at this solved problem, we grouped blue together, we grouped white together, and then we grouped red together. Or it could be red, white, and blue. In other words, this is a sorting problem of three unique values. For example, imagine we have an array consisting only 0 and 1 and 2, and then we need to sort that array. In that case, that would be also a DNF problem. The main idea of this algorithm proposed by Djaikstra is to push all the low values to the left, high values to the right, and we don't care about the mid values, because if you push low values to the left and high values to the right, all the other values will fit into the middle eventually. This is a sorting problem, so it could be solved in different ways. Probably the most obvious way is to just sort it using any well-known sorting algorithm. It could be merge sort or the quicksort. In that case, the time complexity would be order of n log n. Another way of solving this problem would be do some sort of counting sorting. So we count the number of whites, the number of blues, and the number of reds, and then we combine all together. It would be order of n time complexity, but we need to go through the arrays more than one times, so multiple passes is required. The solution proposed by Edgar Djaikstra, it is order of n time complexity and constant space complexity. So this is the best known solutions for this problem, and we are going to discuss the solutions proposed by Edgar Djaikstra. So in this solution, we'll maintain three pointers. So if you look at these arrays, this is partially sorted. What we are doing here is we're going through these values one by one. We know all these values and these values and these values with black color and the question mark in the middle, those are unknown. And we'll maintain three pointers, low, mid, and high. And using those three pointers, we will keep four invariants. So the number one invariant is everything at the left of low is low values. What does it mean? So this is the low pointer. So everything at the left would be low. So here the low values is blue. And then from the low pointer to the left of the mid pointer are mid values. So this is low pointer, including this low pointer until the left of this mid pointer are mid values. And then from mid pointer to the high pointer, including mid pointer, including high pointer, all those values are unknown. We don't know about those values yet, but we are going to reveal those values in our algorithm. And then everything after the high pointer are high values. In this case, this is red color. In another way, we can say that the low pointer is always the first mid value or the first value after the low values. Why do we need that? Because whenever we find a value which is a low value, then we need to swap it with the low pointer. So where can we swap it? This is the place where we can swap a low value. And then the mid value, we can say the mid value is the first unknown value. So we'll always reveal this value and try to find out the correct positions for this value. So in another word, this is the first unknown value. And again, the high value, we said everything at the right of this high value is high value. So high pointer will point to the last unknown value. So if you can understand that or remember that, it will help us to write the correct code for this algorithmic problem. So today I have some playing cards with three different colors, and I will use those cards to explain this algorithm. Let's get to that solution. I'm going to use this playing cards to explain the DNF algorithm. I have colored the other side of this card in three different colors according to the Dutch national flag. I have some red cards, I have some blue cards, and I have some white cards, and we're going to sort it using DNF algorithm. I'm going to shuffle it so I don't, it would be completely random, and I'm going to put it here. Okay, and then I have three pointers. One is the red one, which I will use as a high pointer. One is the white pointer, white. It's not actually white, but I will use it as a mid pointer anyway. And this is a blue one. I will use it as a low pointer. So the first thing first, the initializations. Initially, the mid pointer and the low pointer will go to the first card, which means if it is an array of length n, it would be the zeroth index, and the high value, the red one, will go to the last one, which means it will go to the n minus 1th index. So if you remember, our objective is to traverse the array, reveal each and every card one by one, and find out where can we put that card. And the main idea behind this algorithm is we'll push the low values to the left, we'll push the high values to the right, and we don't care about the mid values because it will be eventually in the middle. So let's get started. So this is our first card. We'll reveal it. We got a red card, which means this is a high value, and our objective is to push the high values to the right. So to which positions we can push it, that's why we have this high pointer. What we are going to do is we're going to swap it with this high pointer, so it will come here, and this one, we don't know the value of this one yet, it will come here. So we just did a swap, and since the high pointer, everything on the right of the high pointer should be the high values, so this high pointer will move forward, it will come here. Our mid pointer is still here, so as I said earlier, the mid pointer will always point to the first unknown value. So these are all unknown, this is the only known values here, and we'll reveal the first unknown here. Okay, so this one is again red. What we will do is do the same, we'll swap it with this one, it will come here, and we will move our high pointer here. So this is our unknown value again, and we reveal it, this is white. So if this is a white, this is the mid value, and we don't care about the mid values. When I say we don't care, that means we're not going to do any swap. So whenever we have a low value, we will swap it with the low pointer. Whenever we have a high value, we'll swap it with the high pointer. But whenever we have a mid value, we're not going to swap anything. But we need to do one thing. We need to move our mid pointer, because the mid pointer will point to the first unknown values. So it's here. So this is already known, and these are all unknown values. So our mid pointer, this one, will move to the next one. And now we'll reveal it. We got blue, that means this is a low value, and whenever we get a low value, we need to swap it with our low pointer. So this one will come here, so this is our low pointer, and this one will come here, and this one will come here. So this one is revealed. So the mid pointer have to move, because mid pointer have to point to the first unknown values, as well as this time we need to move our low pointer also, because whenever we'll find the next low values, we need to swap it with the low pointer. So if our low pointer points to this one, it will actually swap a blue with a with the blues, which doesn't make any sense. And if you remember the invariant, the first invariant is we want to keep every low value at the left of our low pointer. So our low pointer have to move from this place to this place. So now the invariant is maintained. Everything at the left of this blue pointer now is blue. So we will reveal the next one, which is pointed by our mid pointer. Okay, so this one is again blue. So as we did in the earlier step, we need to swap it with the low pointer. So here is our low pointer. So this one will come here and this one will come here. And whenever we're swapping with a low value, we need to move both the mid pointer and the low pointer. So mid pointer will come here and the low pointer will come here. So now the mid pointer is pointing this one. We need to reveal this one. This one is white. So this is the mid value. We don't care, but we'll just move our mid pointer. So now our mid pointer will come here. And now the mid pointer has gone past the high pointer. So that means our sorting is complete. As you can see, blue is grouped together, white is grouped together, and red is grouped together. So that's how this DNF algorithm works. So since we have traversed the array just once, we have checked all the values of this array just once. So that means the time complexity of this algorithm is order of n, and we haven't used any extra space. So the space complexity is constant time or order of one. If you think this explanation helped you to understand the DNF algorithm, please don't forget to like, share, and comment. And if you think that it will be helpful for your friend also, please share with your friends. I will write down the code, the actual code, the description below, so that you can check it out anytime. We'll see you in the next one.